So a couple of months ago, I made a video about Voicemod, and that video got 1 million views.
1 million
views.
So I want to start by thanking you. Thank you so much for watching the video, for liking, for commenting, and sharing the video. It felt really good to know that there's so many of you out there looking for software for content creation, for live streaming, and let's be honest, you guys just wanted to troll your Zoom classes.
Can I help you?
Have you seen my son?
Anyways, in this video today, I want to go over the installation process because it was kind of rushed in the other videos, and hopefully I'll answer a couple of questions that you might have. But right before we start, I'm going to ask you to do me a little favor. Click that like button, okay? And then let's jump into it. Now, the very first step is to go to voicemod.net. On the front page, you'll be able to see all the cool things that they offer. For example, they have a soundboard. They have something called the Voice Lab, where you can create your own voice modification. It actually has some integration with some video games. But let's go back up. Click Get Voicemod Free. And indeed, this is like a freemium product, meaning that you'll get the software for free with limited options. And if you want more options, you can pay for them. But today, we're not going to spend any money, therefore making this free. You can log in with your Twitch account, with your Discord account if you want to, or a Google account. I'm going to log in with Twitch. All right, if you see it in French, it's because I'm French and it just automatically goes to French. But it's basically going to open this box where you can pick where to download the installer. Click Save. And then at the bottom left, it will download Voicemod. Okay, once it's done, you just click on it. Select the language, English, okay. Click Next. Accept the agreement, click Next. And choose where you want to install it. Now click Next and Next, and then install. At the end there, it installed a virtual cable, so it might mute your audio. So basically, you might experience some weird stuff going on with your audio. Do not panic, that's normal. Here, make sure you have launched Voicemod and you can click Finish. I'm gonna bring in my Windows sounds here. So you do this by right-clicking on the sound icon, going to sound settings, and this will bring this up. And you should have output and input. Output is your speakers or your headphones, whatever you're using to listen to the audio. And an input is your microphone. So keep in mind exactly what you're using. In this case, I'm using the Artis 7 as my headset. And as you can see, it switched the microphone to Voicemod Virtual Audio. This is what you want, but remember what your actual mic is. In my case, is Mic Mauno. This is my mic here. All right, let's go back to Voicemod. Here it is. Welcome to Voicemod. Enter Voicemod. Click Enter. And there it is. Okay. Oh, what sound there? Oh, I can hear myself right now. So this is your setup. So you're hearing me twice, basically. When it says select your microphone, make sure you select the mic you're speaking into. When it said select your headphones, if you're using speakers, you select the speakers. So let's continue. Say something epic. There you go. It's installed and working perfectly.
All done.
Oh, you have created a virtual microphone. Now, if you go back to your sound, you will see that it created the microphone, a Voicemod virtual audio device. This is what you need to choose when you want to use Voicemod in Discord, for example, in Skype and Zoom and in your video games. It has to be your default on Windows, for example, if you want it to be default on everything. So when you stop using Voicemod, if you close down the software Voicemod, you should probably go back here and select your actual microphone. A lot of people have been having problems with that. And they're like, oh, I don't have sound on my computer anymore. Just select the right thing that you're using. If you're not using Voicemod, there's no reason why Voicemod should be selected here. Anyways, boom, start Voicemod. So what you need to know is for the free version, you have a couple of voice mods that change on a 24-hour cycle. As you can see here, there's a timer. So that means tomorrow, those will not be the same voices. It will switch. So if you want to have a consistent voice mod that you use over and over again, you need to get the pro version for that. And this is where this will be unlocked. And you can have an idea of all of that. Leave a comment if you'd like for me to test out all of those, right? On top of being able to create your own. Anyways, if you want to hear the effect added to your voice, you need to click bottom left where it says, hear myself. Testing. And now you hear me twice because I'm hearing myself and I'm also recording the desktop audio. And now you only hear me once, okay? Voice changer is here, is also activated. So if you turn that off, and then you put a voice, you're not gonna hear the voice changer, okay? So make sure you have that on and then pick this, AI DJ. I don't know what that is. Let's try it out.
AI DJ, what is going on? An AI DJ.
Wow. So there's the voice changer, and then there's the background effects. The background effects, for example, here was the music. That was very loud and kind of obnoxious, but if I want to hear myself, AI DJ. Let's try baby. Now I'm going to mute myself and my recording software so you can only hear basically what I can hear. So you'll only hear the voice mod.
This is the baby voice for some reason.
This is a cave simulator.
This is called Lil Ma. It's auto-tune with a chorus. And this is what called magic words.
And that's the basics on how to install it. Now, another thing that you can do is actually tweak some settings on the right, see how it sounds, the volume, if you can mix it between your real voice, the actual mod. If you're not hearing yourself when you click hear myself, testing, you should be hearing me twice. If you're not hearing that means you set it up wrong. So you go to settings, and then here, you have to pick the right input and the right output. But if you click on plugins, you'll realize there's a Twitch plugin that people can use bits in order to activate your voice mods. But that's probably for another video, okay? If you're having some issues with the volume of some of the voices, bottom right, you will see that icon here. If you click on it, you will be able to modify that. If it's too low or too high, you can set it up here. There's also a bleeping feature at the bottom here that you can keybind. You can pretty much keybind everything. If I click on it, you'll hear. And it's actually cutting out your voice when you're doing it. So people like to have it bound to a Stream Deck, for example, or a shortcut on their keyboard. In order to access the keybinds, you have to go to settings, and then top you will see keybinds. That's the tab, and this is where you can set it up. Okay, now when it comes to closing Voicemod, you can close it here. It will most likely still be in your tray, so make sure that it's closed here. So right click, click exit, and it will tell you Voicemod microphone is set to default. Your default, blah, blah, blah. To continue the setting, blah, 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 blah. Basically warning you that Voicemod is about to close and you need to switch out from the Voicemod virtual audio. So your Windows is still on Voicemod. You need to go and pick your actual mic. And as you can see now, we have the right mic. Once again, leave a comment if you would like for me to test out all the voices that are available on Voicemod Pro. Leave a like on the video if you would like to see how to set it up so that your Twitch chat can give bits to activate your voices. And talking about Twitch, check me out on Twitch at twitch.tv/gallevel. If you're looking to make some cool gaming logo animations in just a couple of clicks, you can get 15% off playset.net with my link in the description. But that's the part where YouTube shows you which video you should watch next. At the bottom of it, you will see my most recent video, so go check him out and keep on learning about content creation. I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching. Go out there, make me proud. Gallevel out.